Are you kidding, WWE? 3 weeks in a row, and you leave Nikki Bella off TV. A simple cameo is all I ask. Is that too much? I mean, you did a thing on WWE.com a couple weeks back. Why can't you do that on TV? It helps build diva storylines. And now on to the actual show, whatever. I really like what they did with this episode because we got more of the other guys and not just the main event guys. I mean, the way the show opened up, I really liked it because it was guys that normally don't open up the show and normally aren't important. And the best thing is, this actually looks like it's actually leading to something significant that's going to end up meaning something. We had Cody Rhodes, Dolph Ziggler, and Christian all interrupt Triple H, basically pissed off about something. Triple H puts them all in matches that are against their odds, which I was actually looking forward to all of them. And we had Cody Rhodes defending the championship in a 10 jobber battle royal. I don't think we've seen this kind of match too often. Though my only complaint, though, is where the fuck is Tyler Rex when you need him? But besides that, we got Sin Cara versus Sin Cara. We got a run-in from Christian. And in the end, Cody Rhodes stands tall. We had Dolph Ziggler versus the internet champion Zack Ryder. And let me just say this, I'd much rather Zack Ryder be in this position than Alex Riley. Because, I mean, let's face it, Alex Riley, he's kind of boring. His in-ring ability is meh. His mic skills are meh. He's just average at best, and I'd much rather they keep Zack Ryder chasing the championship over Alex Riley. Now, we did have Terry Long come out and make the shocking announcement that there's going to be a tag team match, but it was Zack Ryder that got the pinfall after a face turn from the returning Batista. That's right, random face turn. WWE really has been doing a lot of TNA-like stuff, but I don't know, it kind of works on WWE in my opinion. And then, of course, there was the Christian match where Christian just got basically treated like an afterthought in the whole John Cena thing. I guess I can understand they want to push this storyline and he was kind of just there, just to be there, whatever. But I mean, right after all this, they all get together with Captain Charisma, David Otunga, and they all plot how are they going to get back at Triple H. And I kind of like this. It's actually leading somewhere, giving all these guys an opportunity to shine, giving them all TV time and actually pushing them to look like legit guys in this. And now for the diva segment. Now, can somebody tell me this? What is so special about Best Phoenix? Because I spent the weekend looking at some old Best Phoenix matches, and really, I did not see anything special. I mean, yeah, she's got her power moves, the suplexes and whatnot, but basically all she does is suplexes, clotheslines, and holds. That's basically all she does. Nothing much from what any of the other divas do. So after watching all that, I'm kind of wondering, what is it that makes people say that she's a great wrestler? Is it just because she doesn't look like a Barbie doll? Is that it? I mean, she's a good wrestler and everything, but she's not as great as people make her sound she is. She's like overrated, basically. But basically, this match, same match we got last week, different outcome. Big whoop. I guess we got what we wanted. Divas of Doom win. Yeah, there's nothing interesting coming out of this storyline. And I mean, even if they do win the championships, it's just going to be more of this. More of random matches, just tag team matches every week, and a squash match here and there. Basically, that's just what every Divas rivalry is, and that's just what they're doing with this. They wasted an opportunity here. But anyway, on the bright side, let's look at the botches we had. Kelly Kelly botched her spank. She botched her spank. And Mickie James hit a beautiful crossbody on an invisible woman. And also, once again, Mark Henry looking like a main eventer by squashing another big guy. And Randy Orton did interrupt, which I like. But once again, Randy Orton's just going to win it again and look even stronger. Like, oh my god, he's overcame the odds. We never thought he'd do it, but he finally did it. Randy Orton is not going to leave the main event picture. He's always going to challenge for the Raw title, and he's always going to be a Raw champion as long as he's on SmackDown. The sooner people realize that, the better. So now let's look at the main event picture right now. The main event scene was pretty much just focused on the three guys that were actually in the main event. John Cena, CM Punk, and Alberto Del Rio. They all got commentary time, so great to hear CM Punk on commentary, complaining about his diet soda once again. They're even making Alberto Del Rio look strong, because they basically fucked him over as WWE champion, and now they're trying to make him look strong, trying to say, oh, he's the odds-on favorite, and making him stand tall at the end of the show. He's not going to win. We all know that's not going to happen. But yeah, I guess I could segue this into my Hell in a Cell predictions. Mark Henry versus Randy Orton. Randy Orton's gonna win. That's not a prediction, that's a spoiler. John Cena, Alberto Del Rio, CM Punk. I'm gonna go with John Cena to win this one. The only way CM Punk is gonna win is if it's some kind of screwy ending, and Alberto Del Rio has no chance. So, Kelly Kelly versus Best Phoenix Divas Championship match. Really, even if Divas of Doom win this match, they're not gonna do anything with it. And if they lose it, then that's just gonna make them look stupid, and everyone's just gonna stop giving a fuck. So, either way, this match is pointless. I'm really starting to care less about the Divas as weeks go on. Especially since Nikki Bella is not on TV. Sheamus versus Christian. I want Christian to win. I think Sheamus is going to win. There's my predictions. So anyway, besides all that, Booker T's commentary. I hated it. I hate Booker T's commentary because he contradicts himself. He stutters. He makes no sense. He sounds like an idiot. He yells for no reason. But for some reason, I was actually entertained throughout the show by his commentary, waiting for him to say his catchphrase, like, "Oh my goodness." I guess I'd be like Omar now. I'm actually entertained by how stupid he sounds. Maybe that's it. There you have it. Raw review and my Hell in a Cell 2011 predictions.